Hello, let me introduce the operation instruction of pension monitor N4 to you. The upper left of the machine is an alarm light. According to different alarm levels, there are high, middle, and low alarm probes. At the bottom of the interface is the key to control the shutter. And at the right of the interface is the shortcut button. The first is a record key. When the device is configured with a printer, pressing this key will automatically print the measured parameters. The second is the waveform freeze key. A short press will freeze the measured ECG waveform, so that the doctor can check the abnormal ECG waveform in details. The third is a blood pressure measurement button. Press it to inflate the cuff, then you can measure blood pressure. The fourth is a pension object setting key. You can set the pension's basic information in this interface. The right side is the printer slot. The printer is an optional function. The standard configuration does not have the printing function. The left side of the machine is a thinner interface. This is our standard accessory. The first is the ECG lead cable. Our standard configuration is a 5-lead ECG lead cable. There will be a slot here, aligned with a notch on the machine during installation. Next is our blood oxygen probe. Our standard configuration is an L-dot blood oxygen probe. The interface has a slot, and it is aligned with the slot when installing. The last one is our blood pressure cuff. Connect the blood pressure cuff to the blood pressure extension tube, and the extension tube is connected to the blood pressure interface of the monitor, and the interface will automatically jam. Press and hold the power button for 3 seconds to start the monitor and enter the operation interface. At the top of the interface is status bar. The first item is the time setting. Click to set the specific time. The second item is pension management. Pension information can be set here. The default alarm limits for adults, children, or newborns are different in different modes. You can choose whether the pacing analysis function is turned on or off. And you can create a new pension. Clear the existing data and create a new pension field. The third is alarm area. Click it to display the alarm event, as well as the name and time. Click the ECG setting in the upper right corner. You can set the alarm switch, alarm level, alarm record, alarm upper and lower limits, and the source of heart rate can be obtained from ECG or blood oxygen probe. This is the setting of HRV analysis to check whether HRV problems occurred. Below is the blood pressure value. Click to enter the blood pressure setting interface. You can set the measurement mode. There are 3 modes: automatic mode, continuous measurement, and manual mode. Next is the blood oxygen value display. After you click to enter the blood oxygen setting interface, you can set alarm switch settings, alarm level settings, alarm records, waveform speed, and pulse volume, and measurement sensitivity, all of which can be adjusted. On the right are the upper and lower limits of blood oxygen and pulse rate alarms. Here is the body temperature setting. Our device supports dual-channel body temperature measurement. The right side is the body temperature alarm setting. The last is our breathing rate. The breathing rate setting is meant to set its breathing leads. There are a total of 4 breathing leads to choose from. Choosing a suitable breathing lead can make breathing rate monitoring more accurate. Below the display area is our menu setting bar. The first is the interface settings. There are 5 interface options. Currently, the standard display interface. This is the dynamic trend interface. The real-time waveform is in the middle of the interface, and the parameter trend graph is on the left. You can see the trend changes of the parameters within 2 hours. This is the OxyRG interface display. This interface mainly integrates heart rate, respiration rate, and blood oxygen saturation. This is the display of the other bed observation interface. If there are multiple devices in the department connected to the internet, we can view the parameters of the bed monitoring through the network. This is a large font interface display. The main parameters are enlarged and displayed, which is convenient for medical monitoring. This is alarm silence. This is a record key. The function of those two keys are the same as a shortcut key. This is the information review. There are five items here. The first item is blood pressure review. You can revisit historical blood pressure measurements. The second item is a review of alarm events. You can select a certain period of time and cure the alarm events with this period of time. The third item is a trend graph review. Here we can see the long-term trend changes, such as our heart rate, respiration rate, body temperature, ST segment, blood oxygen, blood pressure, body temperature. The fourth item is a trend list. In the form of a list, a set of data will be recorded at regular intervals. Here you can select the recording interval. The fifth item is waveform playback, mainly for ECG waveform, blood oxygen waveform, and the respirator rate waveform. These are the contents of the information review. This is the graphic feed. This is the main menu. This is non-invasive blood pressure. Click to measure blood pressure. This is a lock screen. After clicking, the shortcut interface is locked and cannot be clicked. Choose a select. Clicking again will unlock. This is alarm setting, which can set parameters such as ECG, blood oxygen, temperature, non-invasive blood pressure, upper and lower limits of respiration rate. This is a sound setting. There are five types of volume, which are heartbeat volume, pulse volume, keyboard volume, alarm mute time, and alarm volume. You can adjust the volume of these parameters. This is patient management, which is the same as the patient management function in the schedule bus. This is the system standby. You can set the shutdown. This is automatic measurement. You can set the time interval for automatic blood pressure measurement. This is the calculation of drug concentration. You can set the total amount, concentration, dose, and other values of the drug to facilitate the reference of data during medical rounds. This is a trend table display. You can view the parameter changes corresponding to each parameter. This is the trend graph display, which can display the trend graph changes of parameters. This is a non-invasive blood pressure review. You can view the historical measured blood pressure values. This is the waveform playback. You can play back the waveform. This is the screen brightness. You can adjust the screen brightness. The last is to record output settings to facilitate the doctors and nurses to capture the moment when the parameter is abnormal. The monitor should be cleaned and deficient regularly, and ethanol and ammonia water are recommended. When cleaning, please turn off the monitor, disconnect the AC power, wipe with a cotton ball, and final dry with a dry cloth. After 12 months of continuous use of the monitor, it is recommended that qualified maintenance personnel conduct a comprehensive inspection and calibration.